Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, more than half of the world's population lives in cities, and that number is growing. Cities are places where human health can either flourish or be destroyed. People living in cities usually have better access to health services and greater opportunities for education and employment, both important enablers for good health. But city life can also expose people to more health risks. Crowded living conditions, sedentary lifestyles, more processed foods, pollution, and traffic accidents. 8 out of 10 cities globally fail to meet WHO's air quality guidelines for air pollution. And every year, we estimate that 3 million people die from diseases related to air pollution: heart attack, stroke, lung cancer, and respiratory diseases. No city can continue to prosper if its inhabitants are sick. Healthy cities breed healthy people. And the opposite is true. When people are healthy, cities and communities thrive. As mayors, you have the power to make decisions that affect the health of millions of people. The solutions are often simple and affordable. The missing piece is political will. Bike paths, car-free zones, parks, reliable public transport, responsible waste management. There are plenty of great examples of cities that show what's possible. Copenhagen, which I know since 1988, with its extensive bike and transit networks, is a European model. About one third of travel in Copenhagen is by walking or bicycle. Curitiba in Brazil is a global model for sustainable urban transport, green spaces, and waste management. Both rich and poor people tend to concentrate in cities. Achieving meaningful progress in health depends on reducing gaps between the best of and worst of communities. For cities to thrive, we need to ensure that everyone has access to services that will improve their health. Public transport, safe and attractive outdoor spaces, healthy foods, and of course, affordable health services. The WHO Healthy Cities Network is an important initiative for sharing lessons and strengthening political resolve. I urge you to use this moment to build the cities of the future that nurture health for all people. I thank you.